Hello and welcome to the ESL Premiership. It's been an amazing couple of days. We've seen 69 teams battle out through a Swiss tournament that was run just from Monday night, and well, it's just really pretty incredible just the amount of teams we've been able to put through. Of course, it's not been without its issues. You know, this match in itself, 37 minutes delayed, but it is what it is. Nonetheless, we have to crown our victors of this qualifier. We have to get ourselves 8 teams for the ESL Premiership Spring 2017, and well, no better way to do it than to follow the evening's games, of course. I'm going to be joined by Jay tonight. Jay, how you doing?
Hey, man, it's been absolutely fantastic casting the past couple of days, so I'm really excited to get into these next few matches here, and we're going to start things off with Reason Gaming versus Enemies in Disbelief. Now, these guys roughly came up with a roughly the same win rate here in the case of Reason Gaming, actually, but end up slightly higher up in the rankings compared to Enemies in Disbelief with 4 wins against Enemies 3. So looking at those statistics, you probably would be able to guess that they'd probably be the odds-on favourite to win here, but they are playing with a stand-in today. We've been having a couple of wire issues, which, you know, is kind of usually typical, but I mean, it's been the case. I mean, it's never been so bad that we've seen for this season at least. It's never been so bad that we have to see a sub out because of the issues connecting to the server. So Reason maybe playing starting on the back foot here, not with their complete lineup. So this could end up swinging either way, in my opinion. We don't know how well the remaining 4 players of the Reason side end up working together. So we'll find out as we go. Enemies in Disbelief, certainly they're still the underdogs in this case. So my prediction is still going to be on Reason, but that would be a very bold statement, if anything, tonight.
And certainly a risky one, of course, just waiting now for this one to kick off. And we're just kind of going in even further to what you're saying. You know, I'm looking across this list of players yet again, and it's a bit of a similar affair to what we did yesterday. I'm kind of looking towards players like Vertigo and Speedy and Hoodlum and saying, you know what, you do have that ability to take these guys down, just really dismantle them as a lineup. But then that's where things begin to go wrong, isn't it? Because you're looking at a team and saying, you know what, you're operating like a machine. You know, you're almost like this puzzle. You have to have every single piece to be able to make it work, especially when you are a team like Reason, who haven't necessarily had too much practice because they're relatively well formed. But, you know, whether that's going to affect them too much tonight, having all these standards come into play, you know, whether it's really all going to work out or whether we are going to start to see some blunders, who knows? Again, only one way to find out. We are going to be going live into this one, though. Here we go. Going to be that knife round. And Dustu, well, I think it's fairly unanimous. You can go either direction.
Indeed, definitely. Like, this is probably the most, this is the, sorry, not probably, this is the most even map in the entire game. So it could really swing either way here. And for both these teams, you know, it could end up coming down to who wins this pistol round, this knife round here, with the favoured side. For Reason Gaming, I believe that their favoured side is going to be T side. So, actually, this could end up working in their favour if they end up losing either way. So we'll find out as Hoodlum is the last man to remain alive here, and we'll just go fooling right there. So Enemies in Disbelief will have their chance to pick their side. And, well, like you said, probably going to be a very even matchup here. I still kind of want to edge it slightly towards Reason Gaming. But, of course, still whether to see whether that well-oiled machine will stay together in this next one. Enemies in Disbelief will take CT side. So Reason may not be that worse off here.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gents. Opinions laid bare. A 60-40 split almost in terms of where this could swing a lot of hope being put onto the shoulders of Reason Gaming. And of course, you know, just have to talk about the importance of this matchup, because, Jay, gone is the Swiss system. We're past it now. That's old news. What we're in right now is the double elimination invite qualifier, and the kind of the real importance behind that and the real grit of the situation is the loser of this match, you can say goodbye to your dreams of competing in the Premiership Spring 2017. It's not going to happen. Your journey here is done and dusted. So Reason, by far, a team who should be in the EPS. You would kind of read off a list of names and go, okay, Reason Gaming guaranteed a spot. Well, this is their time to really prove that they're worth all of these invites and all of this merit, really, as a lineup. And I think for Enemies in Disbelief, it's kind of almost a bit of an SK Hellraiser-style matchup where they're going to come on in, they're going to go, you know what, we can get the upset here. We can actually overcome them and completely snatch away that spot. Because even if Enemies in Disbelief don't actually qualify, even if they beat Reason here and then drop out of the next round, just think about the storyline of them actually knocking Reason out itself. Yes, you know, there will always be the argument of, oh, Reason haven't practiced too much and they do have that sub. Just think about the narrative that sets in motion, especially for the upcoming lands.
Yeah, another thing you've got to consider as well is the fact that this Reason Gaming isn't the same Reason that we saw compete at the ESL Premiership Finals at MCM. This is a very different roster that we're seeing compete here. So when you talk about names that could be in the Premiership lineup, you know, for me, Reason Gaming doesn't immediately spring to mind when you consider their current situation. This is definitely something for them to prove here, and this is going to be their chance to prove it. Like you said, it's do or die for both of these guys. One of these teams is going to get eliminated. We're in the lower bracket for this matchup, and the pistol round is ready to get started. Reason Gaming early in towards the upper tunnels, going to be Vertigo going down immediately. Cinder's going to take that one back. Hildlum's going to get early aggression over towards the B doors, but they're going to get this bomb down pretty quickly for the retake. The enemies in disbelief. They are going to be at the advantage to set up here, but we're going to come down to Reason Gaming's position as the Logsy will get one, and that's going to be a 3-5 situation. Easy headshots comes in for Dancy. Mitch gets one back, but it's a 2-3 situation, and it's going to be very easy pickings, very easy headshots for enemies in disbelief as Dream gets two. We'll shut it down towards enemies in disbelief side.
Yeah, frags are plenty for the CT side, especially with that split push coming from door or window. The timing worked out for them, and Reason Gaming just weren't quite sure where to look, and well, from there, it kind of fell apart. They found themselves over-encumbered with the numbers they were up against, and well, what can you do? It's a situation where you are just, well, out of luck, out of time, now out of money, as it is going to be P250s across the board for this T side. Looking to tap a couple of heads here and there and see if they can perhaps get themselves that early pick, but, well, the UMP is going to be a bit more of the brutal end. A double kill, already easy money to be added into the bank, and, well, P250s still having quite a mare in terms of landing these shots.
Well, despite that, Mitch is going to be able to get Thomas back, but at the end of the day, Reason Gaming aren't looking to win a round here. They're looking to do some damage to the enemies in disbelief side to hurt them in the long run, because they are playing the long game. They got the bomb down in the last round. Probably the best they were looking for in this case is getting the bomb down and losing the round to enemies in disbelief. In this case, they won't do it, but regardless, they will have the economy to buy up here. So AK is coming out immediately. Scout on Vertigo. And AK's armor, lots of utility for everybody else, so Reason Gaming looking in a lot better position this round around, so we'll find out how well they do. But with that being said, enemies in disbelief, they've gone for the double AWP setup, and immediately they're going to put it into good effect as Cinder gets Vertigo, takes him down. The scout is straight out of play for Reason Gaming, and now enemies in disbelief will start things off on the front foot at 5-4.
Exactly, what a way to kick things off. We talk about these two teams, we talk about them fighting with tooth and nail in these buy rounds. Well, an AWP pick right down mid, you couldn't ask for anything better. But the big kind of highlight off the back of that is you can't now get greedy. Enemies of disbelief, they've got themselves an advantage. Don't throw it away. Don't make a simple mistake to allow Reason back on the board. All you have to do now is play the training game, play the information game, sit in the back lines. No need for aggression. No need for anything uncalculated. They are, well, currently doing just that, spread out across the map. They've got themselves a nice passive B site hold, a little bit of presence over towards long. The curveball will be the short aggression rolling on, and Mitch looking for a cheeky one-tap over towards that left corner of the B site, but oh, it's going to be denied. There's one to be picked off for the AWP, and well, tick by tick, that time is going to go on down. Reason Gaming being forced into a bit of an uncomfortable position now, being, well, told to relocate to tunnels, get yourself out, you've got nowhere to go, and they're going to push right into a player, but Mitch, he's going to catch him off guard.
Nicely done. 4-3 situation. It's a 2-for-1 trade in favor of the enemy's side, but he's going to see to try and defend on towards the B site. Cinder gets Speedy, Dancy gets Mitch. And that's all Hoodlum, who can't really do a whole lot as the AWPs are so on point. Enemies in disbelief with a fantastic investment. Both Cinder and Dream getting their money's worth in that round. 3 kills for Cinder in particular will put enemies in disbelief up to 3 rounds here. So Reason Gaming now, a chance to force buy, but it looks like it's just going to be pistols for this next one. The Eco, Tech-9s, P250s, and a bit of armor for one, a flashbang for another. But for the most part, it looks like it's just going to be Rush B. Get this round over and done with and just kind of see what else they can find. But enemies in disbelief, they got this one locked down. They've dropped the bomb. They've picked up all players. And that's going to be the 5-man sweep with a nice triple for Thomas, closing it out for enemies number 4-0.
A very comfortable start as well coming in from Cinder. Not only has been hitting shots with this AWP, but also the flashes have been on fleek. Seen some pretty hefty pop flashes go out on towards that B side. They've enabled him to consistently over and over again get these repeaks. And well, you have to look towards Reed and say, okay, well, what's your play? Seems long aggression is going to be, well, the strat book of choice, but Dancy is already going to meet it, punishes Speedy straight off the bat and says, you shall not cross this ground. You can get the hell out of here if you think you're going to get an easy push. Another flash to go on through. Look at how blind this T-side are. They've got nowhere to look. They're kind of just there staring into the long white just saying, well, just what's going on? Something is awry.
Definitely. I mean, Mitch just lost probably one of the easiest picks onto an AWP I think I may have ever seen, and that probably shows up some red flags for Reason's current form. I mean, that's not really the shots you kind of want to miss here playing in the Premiership. You kind of want to be landing those shots. You really want to be picking it together as many as you can here. And Reason Gaming, they're just not finding those kills that they need to. That being said, they pick up Logsy and Dancy falls through the smoke, so they will have a bit of a line in towards the A sites. Now it's going to come up to Dream to see if he can find the AWP shots. He fires but can't land. Geji will get him the second time around, and that's going to leave Vertigo and Hoodlum to try and plant the bomb, but as the utility falls on towards the site, it's going to deny that fact as it is down. They haven't picked it up, and it looks like the AWP and their rifles will just kind of look to close out any angles on the site. Hoodlum falls, Vertigo, last one to go. We'll trade shots with the AWP, but Thomas is sitting right on that corner to give a 5-0 lead to the favourite of enemies of Disbelief and Reason. Well, honestly, right now would be the time where I call a pause, because this is going to be a very difficult round with 3 AWPs recovered in that last one. Enemies in Disbelief are sitting very highly in the economy, in the rounds, and just in generally in their overall position in this game.
For all intents and purposes, they are kings sitting upon a golden throne, each and every single one of them. So much money in their coffers. We're looking at pretty huge amounts overall of 8,850, 6,600. That can be broken down, but it implies that Reason Gaming are going to get that upset round, which from the last 5... haven't quite seen the case. Is this going to be the welcome change, though? Who knows? At least now it's pistols going aggressive, but they're walking right into an AWP that is just picking them off. A Bastion in the making. He just taps them down. A plant is going to be forced, but USP there to mop it up nice and crisp.
Enemies in Disbelief are just on a ridiculous form. That was some ridiculous AWP play from Dream. Incredible 4K. Like, this is just, they're playing on a level that Reason Gaming just cannot seem to match right now. You take a look at the scoreboard. Mitch is the top fragger at 4 kills, and then the second from the bottom on Enemies in Disbelief got 5. This is not working out for Reason Gaming. In fact, look at some of the players here. Vertigo hasn't even been able to get himself on the board whatsoever in terms of kills. He's just been getting assists. He's been getting the occasional helping hand here. So Reason, they need to come up with something big. And it was going to be this explosive play into B, but already it's been shut down as Hoodlum falls, and now Speedy G and Co are scrambling to try and find a kill here. They trade 2-for-1, but the AWP from Cinder is already in position to trade it right back. 2 kills for him, and a 2-on-4 situation that leaves enemies in Disbelief in a total advantage once again. Bomb goes down, and Reason have to defend this retake here. Oh my god!
Absolute monster decides, you know what? It's still one I'm good getting the picks, but I'm just going to take Vertigo down straight through a smoke, as it is going to be that Mopup comes through. A 4v2 retake, ever so plentiful and ever so comfortable for enemies in Disbelief, aided by what currently seems to be the wrecking ball performance coming out from Cinder. 12-0. Reason Gaming, you need to stop this, man, because in a minute, getting to that point now where you're already starting to lose track of this half, and that was something that I was just about to chime into before we even got this round going, which was, okay, 6 rounds, Reason Gaming, they can still always compete, they can still find those early picks. Mitch, a prime example right now, gets that pick with the AWP down mid. However, once you start to break through to 7, break through to 8, then it may get too far, but this is already better. We start talking about the positives. The positives will shine. Hoodlum gets just another with that rifle. Dancy's Chris one tap back on towards short and a Molotov to go down and a couple of nades to greet as Logsy's gonna throw a fair few out. But, well, do not forget, Reason, they have the man advantage. They shouldn't lose it. And, well, they're gonna secure it even further as Vertigo gets just another.
2-4 situation. Finally, Reason at the advantage, and a Speedy comes around the back. He should be able to spot out Logsy and Thomas. We'll take down Thomas, and now all Logsy just to find there in the smoke gets the bomb down. But you can see that despite that, enemies in Disbelief, they're doing a huge amount of damage to the Reason side here. They've picked off 3 players, so despite the fact that they probably won't win this round with Logsy on 12 HP, it's still going to do a lot of damage to the T side. And at this point, Reason Gaming, they can't afford to take many losses. They're at 7-0 down. They're probably going to pick their first. And this could be certain reset potential here for them if they can't manage to land the next round here. Logsy's going to go peeking on through. He's got himself 12 HP. He has a general idea of where SpeeG is and spots him out. Takes it down with a headshot. Tries to connect it onto Hoodlum. Taps the bomb. Sorry, Mitch taps the bomb. And I think Mitch is actually backing off. He's playing for time here. Logsy now has to go for this defuse. It's going to be up to Mitch to see if he can go for the peek. And Logsy's going to be able to tap him down. But he backs off in time because there's no time for Logsy to defuse, even with a defuse kit. Reason Gaming will finally pick their first. But the key round here, the key story is going to be this next round here. We will see the buy-ups come together. And I'm curious to see how much Reason can get together. It's going to be light on utility, that's for certain. They've got themselves an AWP, 2 AWPs coming out. So definitely very light on utility. But
Don't forget the Auto Sniper 2, Jay. We saw that last round being brought today by Reason Gaming. They couldn't even use it. They had to drop it on that B site. Well, bit of a different story this time around. The CT side looking to use that as almost a pillar of their very own site in terms of the defense aspect. And this could be very uncomfortable as Logseek going to go aggressive towards Long, gets the information that Hoodlum is going to be there to spot things out and possibly even hear some further steps, which already gives a bit of an advantage in terms of any counterplay that the CT side can try and bring to the table. And, well, Reason Gaming, they have themselves that foothold of a round. But as you mentioned, a reset right now in terms of their economy? Well, could pretty much secure the half well and truly in the favor of this CT side as that clock is going to begin to wind its way through. And, well, one that will just keep on going. As mid aggression perhaps could be a call to be made, but, well, I'm looking at the map right now and I'm kind of saying with a bit of foresight, well, I don't really want to be pushing into a combination of Cinder and Dancies right now, judging by the form they've been bringing to the table.
And there's the auto sniper.
There's the auto sniper.
Nice kills from Thomas. 2-for-1, he's done his work. And that gives enemies in disbelief the advantage once again. We Mitch getting one back. Hoodlum does full, however, but the AWPs are in position and the AWPs are all there is to defend. Even so, Cinder is sitting there over towards the B doors. Will get tagged up with a wall banger. But he's playing out of his mind with that AWP. So it would not surprise me if as they peek on through here, he would just be able to shut them down. Auto sniper now in the hands of one. Speedy picks off Cinder. Good kill. 2 versus 2. Trying to see if they can get the bomb down and try and defend Logsy from coming in at the backhand side here. And that's going to be Dream coming in from the other side, and Logsy actually lines them up, sprays them both down, and enemies in disbelief will take their 8th, and Reason Gaming will be reset. So now they've won the half, and Reason have not got much ground to work with here at all.
Not got much ground, and, well, hope, perhaps even another factor that begins to dwindle at this point as Reason stand in disbelief, just being shut down off the back of trading. It seems so rudimentary, but such a tough beast for them to almost handle at this point as they get themselves at least a trade that favors them. But, well, don't forget, you've got rifles pushing you on every single angle, still losing these battles, and, well, they may be low on that CT side. Scout certainly could be a bit of an entertaining affair for Vertigo, but it is still a 4v2.
It's not looking good for Reason. I mean, right now they've not got a whole lot to work with. They've got an AK at least, but with shots like that, and if Dream can pick up shots like that when he's got barely any health, then it might as well just be a throwaway for every single round here. AWP still in position over towards the A site. Gedge has got a little bit of an opportunity here to see if he can shut down as many players as he can, because Cinder and Dream are very, very low. I mean, one shot from this gun can redo it, and he's going to take down Cinder to start things off. They have an idea of where his positioning is, so you can see that. One will rotate over towards the B site to see if he can support our rotation, catch off a rotation, see if he can take an unexpected kill here. But a minute to go now. Gage has got a little bit of work to do here. AK in hand, it's going to come down to whether he can get this kill. The AWP is already peaking on his position. He's moving on through, steadies it at the right time, and takes him out of the action to bring 9-1 in favor of enemies in disbelief. And the economy is riding high for them for a reason. It is not looking very pleasing to the eye. As round 11 comes to be, enemies are in such a huge advantage here now. They'll buy up in a very standard buy. Plenty of money to go around. AWP in their hands, and Reason have just got the pistols to work with in this one.
Nothing seems to be working out in their favor at this point. Losing up against what seems like all odds is unfortunate in this round. At least it is just pistols, and I don't think you'd really be betting too many chips on this being successful, and I think that's, you know, understandable. But, you know, getting back to the point, the buy rounds, there is meritable flak to be thrown at the side of Reason Gaming right now. You still, you know, I think ultimately would expect better. You wouldn't be looking at this and going, okay, 9-1 scoreline to a CT side that consists of enemies in disbelief who, these guys aren't exactly a well-practiced team. They don't sit together and get these scrims day in, day out. It's a bit of a different story. They've just as much experience almost together as Reason Gaming have. And kind of, I do look at the caliber of the players on Reason Gaming and go, okay, there has to be a wrench in the works somewhere. Perhaps a sub is just crushing them, as I mentioned at the start. Perhaps it really is that puzzle mechanism that breaks this T-side. But right now, it doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter what puddle, what issue, it needs to be fixed. Because Reason Gaming are just 6 rounds away from losing their spot and losing any potential of being in the EPS Spring 2017.
Forcefire coming out from Reason as much as they can. Yeah, it's going to be Vertigo that starts things off perfectly, and that's going to be down to Reason, the rest of Reason, to see if they can try and make it work. The Molotov will do some damage. The grenades are going to take some serious damage onto Speedy G. And, well, so far, Reason, they're keeping enemies at bay. 5-on-4 situation, and like you said, you know, it's going to be a very difficult situation for them if they can't manage to win the next few rounds, because, like you said, six rounds away, Reason Gaming are at the Premiership, and now we're in a 3-on-3 situation where, well, enemies have got themselves the auto-sniper, and we've seen how deadly Thomas can be with that. If he can put it into greater effect, if he can get himself even a double kill, a 2-for-1 trade out, then that's going to be all said for naught for Reason Gaming. A 2-versus-1 situation. Maybe a bomb plant might be able to bring them one back, but other than that, like, I don't see a whole lot in Reason Gaming. I was expecting this match to be a lot closer than this, and it disappoints me the fact that it's not, but a minute to go now, Reason Gaming could still pull something out of the bag here. So we will see the players rotating on from mid and from T-spawn towards the tunnels. It looks like it's going to be a B hit, but look at what's placed on B. It's Thomas with an auto-sniper. Oh, no, and this is just not looking that great at all. Now, finally, the auto will chime in. Headshot immediately drops the bomb, calls in the info, and enemies are already on the rotation here. It's going to be up to Vertigo to try and see if he can pick his AWP shot. The moment he peeks up, it's got to land it, and he will do so. 2-versus-2, flashing their way on towards the site. It's got to be Cinder to try and take both down. Picks up the first, picks up the second, and enemies just shutting down Reason Gaming at every single hurdle. It is not looking good to beat the boys in red at the moment.
16-3, 14-4. Those are just some of the war chants that are being brought to the table right now by names such as Thomas, by names such as Cinder. It is happy days dream. Every single person pretty much on this enemy's disbelief side is fragging where applicable in Reason Gaming. Well, perhaps it is starting to become common knowledge why they turned down this UKGT invite. Maybe, as they said at the time, they're just not quite ready. Especially with the sub being thrown into the mix, as Logsy now just aggressive towards Long, looking to really wipe through these pistols, and, well, fairly successful so far up until that very own sub will battle on through with the Tech-9 close range. Logsy going to burn away in his own fire in the flames at that, but still, going to be a 2v3. An AWP shot going to be a miss over towards Long, and, well, that will prompt that final rotate coming in from the CTs.
Gage has got the bomb, they have the info on themselves. And Thomas just spamming his way on through, no scraping. I'm going to hit something. If he pulled off the lucky shot, then I would have just dropped my headset and walked away from the computer. But not going to happen today. Unlikely situation to be in. Bomb's still in Reason's control, so they can work off this round. The question is what they're going to do to try and make this one work. AWP in the hands of Gedge. Deagle as well on to Vertigo. So not a whole lot to work with, and well, the current situation that Reason are in, I'm surprised they haven't gone ahead and tried to rotate over towards the B site, because there is no presence from the CTs over towards the B site. They don't know that, but they do know that there is a lot of presence over towards the A site, and, well, I don't think they want to be saving at this point. They wouldn't get any money from it. Maybe Gedge with the AWP might be a good idea, as Dancy gets Vertigo down, and now it's going to be Gedge moving into position finally. He's going to spot out one, but he misses the shot, and that's not what you want to do. Again, you cannot make these mistakes, Reason, when you're in such a crucial position. Cinder's trying to spot him out, taps away, picks up the headshot, and enemies in disbelief. They're now just BMing each other at this point. They know, they've realized they're in a fantastic position to just run away with this one, and Reason Gaming will be back up for the bye once again. They've lost all 5 rounds in a row. It has been a ridiculous half for enemies in disbelief as the double orb setup comes out from Reason. Hoodlum can't even land his shot, and Dancy shuts it down. At least Vertigo will get one back to bring it to a 4-versus-4, but AWP still in play for both sides. Second one picked up for Reason. I have 2 AKs to back it up, and they really need to make this next round work. They really need to make as many rounds work as they can at this point.
Quick flash over towards tunnels is going to be met by an M4 and a bullet to the head of Mitch, as it is going to be equaled out to a 3v3-1. Very rapidly, a lot of a changing pace as a quick rotate through CT is going to be the call to be thrown in by the CT side, whose name, like we said, is almost living to be rather ironical at this point when you look at the context of being in disbelief. The one tap should be found onto the Cranium of Cinder, so far so good. Perhaps this is the positivity that we're looking for. Can't Dancy do anything from CT? Gonna be met with just another flash, so certainly a bit of a blinding affair. The cross from Reason Gaming should be easy. They don't even need to. They can plant for sure, as Vertigo is gonna do. But the angles are gonna be held. Already one to be connected. A second now. We search for Vertigo. Gonna land the shot though, with the AWP not quite missing this time around. And that could be enough to at least stop Reason Gaming from finding themselves in a 14-1 predicament.
Dancy, last man alive, and Reason, they can't possibly lose this one unless they really fluff it out. Gedge tapping away, but his shots just aren't on point, and they're really going to try and see if they can take down Dancy. Finally, the headshots will come in, and Reason will pick up their second. But it's very far gone at this point. They at least need this third round so they have the buffer. If the in the event that enemies do take the pistol round, then they'll at least have a chance to get a rifle round on the board for themselves. So, Reason now, up with another 4-by. AK on Speedy G finally gets it, and Vertigo's finally got his reaction times on point to take down Thomas, and he's looking even further through the door to see if he can spot any more crossing enemies right now. They're just going to rotate over towards the A site. I think actually there's some information gathered from the AWPA of the enemy's side, just trying to spot out anybody going towards the B site. I don't think they managed. I think they managed to get it. Now the information getting from all the footsteps over towards Long Mid is going to be able to take down one, but there's Dainty with the AWP, gets one back. Logs is going to spawn to Speedy G as Dainty trains him out. It's a 2-versus-3 situation. Still favouring Reason Gaming, and as Syndic falls, it's going to be Dainty once again left in a 1-versus-3, and the bomb's already on rotation. Reason know his positioning. They know where they need to go, and they're going to head straight over towards the B site to try and get this bomb down and really throw Dainty for a loop here. 3-versus-1 situation. Reason finally at a massive advantage. An advantage that they cannot afford to bluff here.
Even then though, even if, you know, on paper around that is almost certainly going to go in favor of Reason does take place, what sort of half is that? You do have to look at that and go, is that going to be something they can bring back in a second? As it is going to be Dancy just to push him through, but the minute he makes his position known, he does get a bullet delivered right to his head, and that is going to be the parting gift of this first half.
Well, Reason have the buff up, 12-3, and they'll really want to win this pistol round just to try and secure themselves a good chance here. So it's going to be all in his buy-up, it's going to be all in their performance during this next one. Very standard buy-up from Reason Gaming, armor and Diffuse kit. Enemies in disbelief for going in with a Tech 9. Would like to see that drop to somebody else to go for Raid Boss. But we'll see how well they go. As it's going to be all players in towards Long. Taps away from Mitch. And Vertigo's already taken down to full HP. One shot from Mitch takes down one. And they're looking to trade it right back. There's Dancy coming on to Mitch. 4-on-4 situation. And actually, it leaves enemies in disbelief in a very nice advantage in terms of health. They're going to get themselves straight up towards the presence on the A site. Trades 1-for-2. As now it leaves enemies in a good advantage. Gedge gets one back. Logs is playing Lurk and takes down Speedy G. All on Gedge now, sitting in the CT spawner. 1-versus-2 situation to try and retake it. And he's going to try jump and take down Dancy, but he can't find it. As now the USP has to try tap away. And it's going to be all Gedge to try and make a 1-versus-2 work. A retake work. No defuse kit in his hand. He's got to work quick. And enemies have to give him the chances.
They know he's there though. There's just not really too much hope. Yes, it's a 1v2 and, you know, arguably something that's doable, but in that sort of angle being held when they're just not quite facing, well, there really isn't too much you can do. Time is always going to go in favor of the T side. And yeah, I think there are some very notable comments to make about that round. Like, you know, some very late rotates coming in from Reason Gaming. I think, you know, Bart has made a very good comment about this just a second ago, saying Speedy was basically still on B for all intents and purposes, only just crossing down to mid. Yes, could have been trying to aid for a bit of a waterfall drop, but at that point, it was all a little too late. They needed the support on that site, and, well, it just wasn't quite there. As now we are sat at a 13-3. Gezi is going to find a quick tag with the scout, one that eventually leads to a frag. Can they hold on to this advantage, or are we just going to see just another slippery slope that eventually leads to the penultimate death of Reason Gaming in this qualifier?
5-on-4 situation. Favors Reason again. Of course, with only one player falling, however, it could very easily turn back the tide. A Galil recovered for Reason. They're going to have to put it to good work unless Logsy does that and shuts down two with Cinder backing him up to get Hoodlum. Speedy G engaged now. Last two alive. Speedy G falls engaged once again in a 1-versus-4 clutch situation and can't do a whole lot with the scout. It will be Thomas to shut him down. And that leaves enemies in disbelief. 14-3, one away from match point. And Reason's hopes of getting into EPL will just be shattered. And after turning down the likes of UKGT, it may be a bit of a mess for them. So 14-3 now. Two scouts coming out from Reason. They will force buy their way on through. A bit of a desperation move right here. But so far, they're not managing to make it work because they can't even land tags down towards the middle areas. Now Logsy challenging onto Vertigo. Takes him out of the action. Genji also falls. 3-versus-5 enemies. Massive advantage here going into round number 18.
And SG, perhaps scope weapons the way forward. Call of Duty, here we are. As Mitch will be the next man, a knife to go out towards Hoodlum's chest. And, well, it's almost getting a bit awkward at this point as Speedy, the last man, not quite over towards B this time around with late rotates, but still towards the top of mid. And, well, what can he do in this scenario? I don't know, it's a 1v3, the HP is very, very low, so just a shot here and there can make it back to the realm of possibility. Got to push through a smoke, well, almost asking for it at this point. This 15-3 is going to be the scoreline we find ourselves calling upon. It's got to be said, this is the value of practice as a team. Reason Gaming, they haven't really been able to put in the hours due to various different reasons. It's been a bit of a struggle, and that's why invites and such have been a bit of an awkward topic. But at the end of the day, this is why you need practice.
Yeah, for Reason Gaming, it will be a lesson well learnt here, as it looks like, well, almost looks like it should just be the end here, although Hoodlum does pick two, so maybe I might be speaking a little bit too soon, maybe I might be jumping the gun, but a 3v5 situation favours Reason Gaming. And Reason Disbelief, though, still strong in terms of their own weaponry. Three snipers, two of which are AWPs, and one of which is in the hands of Cinder, who we've seen do nutty things this match. He's going to take down Gej. Only pick one back for enemies in disbelief. Two for one trade out. He's Reason that a slight back foot, nothing they can't get back from, with information just looking to be gathered by the enemies. Right now, it will be Reason Gaming just holding themselves back, waiting for an opening to pick a couple.
Let's see if they can at least try and make this look like a bit less of a bleak scoreline, of course, when you look on paper at a 16-3. You never really want to look at it again, so hopefully we can see Reason Gaming begin to at least try and put up as much of the fight as possible. Of course, the context is that they have that man advantage, as you say, and hell, pushing it even further as Mitch going to find another one towards Cinder, utilizing that SG. Things are looking to at least turn up a bit, unless the Deagle of Hoodlum is about to go absolutely crazy. Finds one, looking now for a second. Mitch, gonna close him down.
And there we are, now Reason will open up a chance. The question is, can that chance go on to be the real comeback for them? And if it is, then I will be surprised and very impressed with this Reason lineup. Maybe they have a lot more potential than we really give them credit for. Right now, all of the enemies in disbelief are going to go fast towards the B site. They've got P90s, SMBs to try and shut it down. Sprays come through. Gej gets one. It's going to be Thomas to get Speedy G. And now Sketch to see what he can find. Onto Dancy, takes him down. Gets Logsy out and takes down Thomas as well. A 3K to hold down the B site. And as Mitch taps away onto Cinder, can't find him entirely. He'll have to get this bomb down to extend himself a little bit longer and try and see if he can keep the enemies in at least a stable situation, economy-wise and all. Meanwhile, the rest of Reason Gaming are closing in on towards this site here. So Cinder in a 1v3 situation. This time, it's going to be enemies on the back foot here. And a great play from Gej, finally showing up in a way that he really kind of needed to in this matchup. 4 kills for him. Will put himself at the top of the leaderboard. And may have just saved Reason this round here.
May have saved it, but Cinder still needs to pull off a godlike act, almost a 1v3 if he wants to take this one home, knock that ball out of the park. Vertigo gonna slaughter a couple of shots through the door with that AWP. Now the angle just gonna be held. Cinder looking to greet him with a swift one tap, misses the shot. It's gonna be an error. This thing's become always a bit more quickening now. Cinder knows he has to get that bomb down. Has to bait a response, almost pushes in towards the door. Now looking to go for perhaps even a peek. Could line them both up here, could get a double kill, but he doesn't expect it. He doesn't expect the second player to be just that close. And Hoodlum, he gets to take advantage of that with the Deagle. Snaps it ahead. What was a chance was rapidly crushed. There's Reason Gaming, they do keep it going against all odds. It's now 15-5. And enemies in disbelief. Their economy is no more.
I saw an alternate reality flash before my eyes right there, where Cinder just shut down the entire Reason Gaming and really hurt them. And now Reason Gaming with this newfound spirit, it's BDG with a newfound spirit, is going to shut down the entire enemies in disbelief presence up towards mid. The ace comes in for the man, and he just shuts it down for the T side. Reason Gaming now. It's a play like that that really spurs teams and, you know, lineups into really performing very, very well. So Speedy G might be the man of the hour who might bring Reason Gaming back into this one. It's all going to come down to whether they can still match up against enemies of disbelief. Mitch starts things off and takes one down at 54 HP, and he walks away totally unscathed from it. So playing smart now, Reason Gaming playing smart and playing skilled. Vertigo gets one, gets a second onto Logsy, looks for the third onto Dancy, almost finds it with the flick, but it's just going to be holding out towards the longhouse. Bombs over towards that general direction. One player in short, Speedy G is going to call that out with the information, or does he? I'm not 100% sure. I think, yeah, Mitch has got that area covered. So 3v5, favour of Reason Gaming. Enemies in disbelief might just be in disbelief after that play, as they are at the back foot.
Hoodlum finding just another. His AWP is really building up one hell of a tally at this point. Hoodlum, of course, on just one, but Vertigo, that early double kill, and it is happy days for Reason Gaming. But there is one very, very big question, one on everyone's mind. Is this a sudden spur of life, or is this just a short stint, one that makes just a premature ending? And, well, that's really what we want to see. Oh, come to life in these next couple of rounds, as it is going to be Thomas to put up a bit of a fight, leave us in a 1v3 at least, which is, you know, certainly doable. But with 35 seconds on the clock, that could make things just a little bit more difficult. A smoke going to go down, a flash to go off, and the distance just to the make that cross a little bit more of an easier one. But Vertigo, well, I wouldn't want to have to deal with him, but Thomas, he's going to get away with it, not dropping on towards CT potentially. Yeah, he's going to get spotted out and dinked retrospectively. Jay, surely this can't happen.
I don't know. It looks like it might. Oh, thank God Speedy G shuts it down before Thomas can get away with a play like that. But he leaves as the only man surviving for the Reason side. So massive economy damage for the enemies in disbelief done. So credit to both Thomas and to the Reason, Thomas as an individual, for managing to pull off a massive 4K to almost bring the end in sight for enemies in disbelief. And for Reason, as just a general team play, working well to see if they can shut it down. You noticed during that round towards the end that all of Reason just locked out angles and just looked to see if they can shut him down before they can end up going aggressive. And once the flashbangs were set out, and once the flashbang and once the smokes were landed, Speedy G ended up pushing out at that point after his teammates had pulled it in. So good team play from Reason, just looking to try to play for the comeback rather than the individual skill. But at the same time, you got to give credit to Thomas.
Looking for a couple of early kills here and there. Will be Reason Gaming just trying to make a bit of a staple mark out of these picks. Well, unfortunately, losing Mitch isn't a helpful factor at all. Could this be the very, very end? They got 1 minute 15 to let us know, just prove us wrong almost. Like that, to keep fighting the good fight almost. There's another to be claimed by Thomas Gersh. Next in line, well, only three left remaining, an auto sniper, an AWP, and a rifle. Speedy G, Vertigo, and Hoodlum. Three very unique players, three very talented players. History in the books for sure, but can they make it happen this one time that counts? Who knows? Speedy, gonna find one, makes it two, makes it to three, tags them both down, gets the dinks. That's an impact in itself now, makes this one back to the realm of possibilities. Vertigo gonna take down Thomas with that auto sniper. Leaving us to a 2v2, pitted with Dancy's at just 9 HP. That's such an easy amount to deal with in a long shot. As long as Dancy's doesn't get that opportunity to take that first peek and get that first shot down, then that's a frag that Reason can take. I'm not quite sure what I'm looking at in lower tunnels right now, but, well, at least they're talking about what they're going to do.
20 seconds on the clock, so whatever they're talking about, they better act on it pretty quickly, because this timer will tick away, and for enemies in disbelief, this may not work out, but this might be genius. Get the bomb up there and just get it planted on the A site. It looks like they're not even going to expect this. The bomb will go down, planted for sure, and that is beautiful from enemies in disbelief. As Vertigo leaves the site entirely, this could end up coming down to the wire at this point. Hoodlum's now rotating in with the AWP. Gonna see if he can spot out anybody, but he's got himself a P250 to try and see if he can work with. We'll go fast, and Cinder's already got the angle worked out, so now he's just got to peek on through, and we'll try land the no-scope. He won't be able to. So now Vertigo, to save Reason Gaming in a 1v2 situation, peeks out onto Cinder, takes him down, and now Dancy, 9 HP up against a 400, and Vertigo can't even do it. It's gonna be 16-7. And what looked like the comeback for Reason Gaming will turn into despair as they are out of the ESL Premiership to losing to enemies in disbelief.
What a game, and what a round to lose, just of all rounds to look at. It's so disheartening just to say, you know what, Reason Gaming had so many flawless rounds on that comeback, so many perfect plays. Speedy getting that double kill towards the end, getting those double dinks as well, to almost total up to what would have been a very influential 4K. But then to lose a round in that sort of fashion, where we do see a Ruse come to play of that push up towards A, I don't know if I feel comfortable saying that they got brained. I feel like that was just blunders across the board on both sides. A bit of an interesting affair in lower tunnels, but a very embarrassing matchup overall for both teams.
Indeed, but certainly more embarrassing for Reason Gaming, as they are done for the night. They are done for the Premiership, and they can kiss their chances of LAN finals goodbye. As enemies in disbelief will advance to face off against FM Esports, who didn't get out in the Cavs versus FM matchup. So We'll have a look into a couple more games and bring you those from the ESL Premiership. He's been Flakes, I've been Jay. Back in just a little minute.